Traders, I'm done for the day. Let me go through a short recap of my trading session today. I started my day with a beautiful winner in SWKS, made over $2,000, almost $2,500. But then came TWOU and VIPS and took me down, two losers after beautiful winner. And at that point, I was down like $200, maybe $300. But then came two beautiful winners. Took them some time, FSLY and Boeing, and I want to go quickly through them, which really saved my day, and LK small loser, which could have been a small winner right now. Anyway, I'm going to finish up $2,700 for the day, which is beautiful because it's my third green day for the week. I've done approximately the same on Monday, over 6,000 yesterday, and this number here today, so I'm up like $11,000 for the week, maybe 12, I'm not sure. Anyway, that's a perfect week so far for me. Very green week. And I want to go through my trades today just shortly because I think I have something very important to say about some of my trades today. Now, let me go through the beginning. SWKS was my first trade today. I'm going to show you that in 1 minute candles here. So that stock was and still is down. Right now it's down 2%, but it started much lower than this, maybe 4%. So as you can see, it started down. And what I really, really like is to see stock in this position moving up, then take the pullback. So I posted it in the trading room under 97.20 for a short, which was right over here. And that was a good call because it came down. That was a beautiful winner. And then I saw it's failing and it started to move higher. And I posted it in the room over $98, which was at the highs here, and a whole number, which in my opinion, again, was beautiful. And it really did move up very nicely. But at the point where I'm posting it in the room, I missed it myself because I was posting it in the room. So you guys owe me money, especially you guys who took it. Anyway, that was a beautiful trade for the long side too, approximately 1 point. But I missed this trade. Then came two losers, TWOU. The sad thing about TWOU that I was not mistaken. That was the sad thing. I posted it for a short under 97.20. Under 2370. 2370 was right over here. Right over here. And I thought that once it's going to come down under this consolidation here, it's probably going to hit a new low and continue. It did hit a new low, but it did not continue. It came up and continued up. Now, I do not move out on spikes. That green candle here was a spike. I never move out on spike. I waited for it to pull back down. It did. And then it came over this candle's high. At the point where it came over this candle's high, over 30, 24, 30, very sad. I stopped my trade. I should have done that. I couldn't have known it's not going to continue higher. At that point, it was up maybe 5%. It's down now 3%. But at that point, it could have continued higher. So I did the right thing. But sadly, I was really right. I mean, the reason I took this one for the short side is because it tried to move higher, it failed, came down, it was holding near the lows. This looks like a very beautiful momentum trade. It looks like a very nice bear flag formation. Sometimes you just don't get lucky. That's it. You just don't get lucky. And it came down, moved up, more than just a spike. And then look at this beautiful formation and it continued coming down. But, you know, that's the whole thing about trading. Sometimes it's just the entry point, the timing, and so on. Let's go to VIPS. VIPS was a short. I posted in the room under 1128. And that was right over here in the same idea. I mean, the stock is down right now, almost 5%. It was more than that earlier. Tried to move higher, failed, came down, shorted it. My target was right here, 1105. But it just touched this point. I missed it. And then it came up again. So I was looking for something like 20, 25 cents and I just, and again, maybe I was right, but I missed it. And then it moved higher. Anyway, it was a losing trade for me. The ones I really want to talk about is FSLY and Boeing. I think this is very, very important. So really stay tuned. We're going to talk about this right now. And this is something that is important to each and every one of you because I know many of you guys did not enjoy FSLY as I did, and why? Now, I posted FSLY long for over 2055, which was right over here. Now look at this beautiful formation. This stock is up today almost 13%. It was up like 10% at that point where I posted it for long. Now take a look at this beautiful upside momentum. Take a look at this amazing consolidation. There was a huge seller, if you remember, at 2050. And I said that once it's going to go over, it's probably going to come higher. I posted it over 2055, and then look at this beautiful, huge spike up. Well, I was probably waiting for more, or it just happened too quickly. I did not get my chance to take my partial there. And then what happened? A huge spike down. Now, you do take your partial on spikes if you're on the green side, but you never move out on spikes if it goes against you. Why? Because, you see, guys, FSLY is just trending higher. It really did not do anything wrong. Look at the chart. Did it do anything wrong? The stock is uptrending. What do you think? Stock is up 10% and then it spikes down. It's a huge spike down. That's a point from 21 to 20. So that's a 1 point spike down. Did you guys survive it? Many of you did not. I've seen some remarks earlier. If you want to mention it right now, it's human not to survive it, really. It is human not to survive it. The thing is, if you had the right quantity, if you know that you're not supposed to be moving out on spikes, then you should have survived it. I mean, FSLY, did it do anything wrong? What would you expect happen here? I mean, why did it come down 1 point? The reason it came down 1 point is because of a lot of weak hands came in with me right here. When I took this one long and it spiked up, there were a lot of weak hands that came in. What do I call by weak hands? I mean, it's certainly not the one who came in where it was initially down and then it moved up and a lot of people came in. If you bought it somewhere around here, you're not a weak hand. If you bought it with me, you're a weak hand. Why are you a weak hand? Because you expect a profit, but when it comes down 30, 40, 50 cents against you, you're out. And you're the one who's really initiating this spike down. I'm sorry, I'm calling you all you. It's certainly not all of you. But the thing is, a lot of novice traders would do that. They would just get scared away as it moves down, and this spike down would take them out. Now, I don't care what is your quantity, but if you traded too much quantity, you were taken out, probably. If you took the right quantity, you probably survived it. What is the right quantity? It's different between you and I and many other. It depends on how much money you are willing to lose. It depends on how much money you have in your account. It depends on your financial situation. It depends on so many things. It depends on your mental situation. It depends on so many things. The question is whether you could have survived it or you couldn't survive it. And I bet many of you did not survive it. This shouldn't happen. It didn't do anything wrong. It's uptrending. The weak ends were taken out and it returned to the highs. And that's a beautiful, beautiful trade for me. Almost $2,000, and I'm still riding 100 shares for more than a point. Now, almost the same thing happened in Boeing. Posted Boeing over 365. Actually, it was a trade that was posted by one of you guys. I'm pretty much sure. I can't remember who posted it. Anyway, it was a trade that was noticed by some of you guys. I can't remember. I think it was Linda, but I'm not sure. Anyway, Boeing moved up recently. If you watch the daily, it's moving up quite dramatically after this incident with the 770s, whatever it is. I can't remember the name of this plane, the MAX anyway. So it's just getting back to the highs. Hold on a second. Back to the daily here. Look at this spike up in Boeing. That's a daily 2 days ago, a small pullback day. Then you would expect it to continue after it rests, after some profit taking, you would expect it to move higher. So initially when we watched the daily, I liked it, and then I was looking for an opportunity. But I was looking for an opportunity here, and it spiked down. Then I thought, well, Boeing's not going to return, but it did. And then my trigger, the one I posted in the room over 365, became much more interesting because it failed to move higher, lower, and it came back up. And look at the 365 again. That was beautiful. But you know what? That was beautiful only if you did not notice this bottoming tail here. So if you're looking at this bottoming tail, once we moved into this trade, it continued to move higher, like 30, 40 cents, maybe a bit more, 47 cents or so. Not enough for a partial in Boeing. But then it came all the way down here to 36440. So this stock came down 60 cents under our entry point. But again, just like FSLY, it did not do anything wrong. Just take a look at the chart. Is there anything wrong with Boeing behavior? There was something wrong here. If I would have moved in earlier, this would have probably taken me out. It is right to be taken out by a very big move as long as it's not a spike. But again, I can't remember exactly what happened there because I was not trading it. But it's definitely wrong. If you're long and it spikes down 60 cents, it's definitely wrong to move out. So again, it has to do with your quantity, it has to do with a lot of things. Don't get this kind of big moves take you out. Now take a look at Boeing in 5 minute candle. Nothing's wrong there. So both Boeing and FSLY, nothing really happened there. You just need to survive this pullback. So if you do the right thing, you end up in green territory. I'm up $2,700. If you do the wrong things, I mean, you could have had a loser. If I would have had a loser in Boeing, if I would have had a loser in FSLY, and if I would have been a novice trader, I'm telling you, I've been there. I may have not survived FSLY and finished this one in red. I may have not survived Boeing and finished it in red. I mean, it's only a matter of a few years back. So you see, well, for me, more than just a few years back, because I'm trading for 20 years now. But the thing is, if I would have had two losers here, and I started with down like $300 here, and I also had a $500 loser in LK, this could have been one of my worst days in the past month. If you trade correctly, that's the difference between a very nice green day, $2,700, and losing day. So there's a big difference between somebody who knows about trading, knows the rule of trading, and can control his emotion to a trader who's just starting out. If you're just starting out and you couldn't survive Boeing and you couldn't survive FSLY, I've been there, I've done that. You will also, just like I did, go through this and survive it if you have enough time, if you have enough money, and enough discipline. So guys, thank you for trading with me today. It was really beautiful. You guys on YouTube, thank you for participating with us too. And I'll be very happy if you give us a thumb up now. Hope we've done enough to deserve it. I think we did. So enjoy the rest of your day. I certainly did enjoy my day today. And I'll see you all tomorrow. Bye, traders. Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to join the TradeNet Trading Room for a free 14-day trial. TradeNet has educated more than 30,000 professional traders worldwide since 2004, and its Trading Room is one of the world's leading trading communities. Click here to start your free trial. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.